children at home. You're welcome to our online classes. I'm Anne Folari. I'll be taking you on Vocational Aptitudes Primary 5. In our last lesson, we look at simple machines. And we say machine is any device or instrument that we use in accomplishing various tasks. And most often than not, such tasks are not achievable without the help of some devices. And such devices that make us to do our tasks more easily and at a faster rate are machines. We cannot lift our car with our bare hands. That was what we learned. And to fix the tires, we need a jack to do that. The jack which we use to accomplish that task of lifting that car is a simple machine. Then we also spoke about simple machine used in accomplishing tasks like the lever. We look at the pulleys. We look at the inclined plane, the screw jack, etc. We even spoke about an opener being used to open a soft drink. That's your bottled drink. By the time you use an opener to open the soft drink, that's a simple machine. Then we look at our tin quarter, which we use to open a tin tomato container or even pig milk. Even though it has been modified now, you notice that most of these things like sardine, when you want to open it, there's already an inclined metal on it. You just pull back and it opens. Those were what we learned in our previous lesson. And also, if you have been following, we have done our work from page 101 of our vocational textbook up to page 106. Now, today we'll be looking at classes of lever. That was what I promised you in our last lesson that we'll be looking at today. We have three classes of lever, and these are the first class lever, the second class lever, and the third class lever. In our last lesson, we say a lever is one of the most efficient and simplest machine for lifting loads. So these lavers are in three categories: the first class, the second class, and the third class. Now, what do we mean by the first class lever? When we're looking at the first class lever, the type of things that fall in this category are the load, the fulcrum, that's your pivot, or the effort. Now, in a first class lever, the pivot is between the effort and the load. What do we mean by that? Like, an instance of the first class lever is our seesaw. We have it on our field, remember? It's near KG1 class. Yeah. Now, let's say Goodness is sitting on the other end and Jedidiah is sitting on the next end of the seesaw. These two people are the load. And then the pivot is the middle, where if he goes down, she will come up. If he goes up, she will come down. Another example of a first class lever is a claw hammer. It is used to drive nail into wood and also for removing it. What about the scissors we use or tailors use? It is used for cutting. So the cloth being cut is the load. And the middle of the scissors is the fulcrum or the pivot. Then the handle is the effort. The way you hold your scissors, that is the effort. What about pliers? It is used for holding a piece of work. So it can be used for cutting and also twisting. Then the common opener that is used for opening, those are our first class lever. Then let's come to second class lever. In this case, the load is between the effort and the fulcrum. Now, stapler that is used for attaching documents together with the use of a staple pin is a second class lever. An opener is used for opening bottle top lid. That one too is a second class lever. What about a wheelbarrow? A wheelbarrow is used for packing things from one place to another. It falls under the second class larva. We see larva is a simple machine you use to lift things. The third class larva is the effort is between the fulcrum and the load. An example is a fishing rod. We know that fishing rod is used for fishing, and also trunks. When if you have seen a blacksmith before, those people that make hoes, our cutlasses, some of them even make mold pots. They use trunks to hold hot objects. So that falls in third class larva. I want you to make use of our class forum to drop your questions. And also, I want you to read through all that we've learned and then attempt the exercises on page 111 of your vocational aptitude bounty textbook 5. Stay safe, remain blessed, and let your parents bring your work on Friday. Then they will come and pick it on Monday. Thank you.